Because they put the kimchi in the start of the winter,
yes.
So it goes all along till spring.
Wow.
Yeah.
Is that process just for storing the kimchi, or is it fermenting in there?
It's
or is
both.
It okay?
It's both storing and fermenting.
Okay.
Yeah.
I wonder if some people don't know what that napa cabbage looks like. Yeah, because it's a show. Which is what you make kimchi, right?
Yeah. This is the cabbage that we use to make kimchi. We put it in water for a while, salt water, and when it gets, when it soaks all the salt, we put all kinds of spices and ingredients in it, in, like between leaves, and then when it's a perfect kimchi, put it in a pot or like container. Nobody thinks they are like studying a lot. But when you hear like stories from other countries like America or other countries like France, Japan, like me and my friends will be so upset and so mad that we studied this much. Yeah, but it's very common.
Wouldn't you start learning a second way?
Second language, English, it's really big part of the Korean education right now. So when I was young, I started learning English when I first went into elementary school. But nowadays, babies start to learn English with Korean, maybe in kindergarten. And we have English is like, it's not even second language now, it's like similar to Korean, the status. And if you go to middle school and high school, you can learn Japanese, Chinese, or some schools have different languages, French, Spanish, but Japanese and Chinese are common. English is everywhere.
We had a Japanese girl who stayed at my friend's house, and we took her to a wedding in Casa Vega, and this is a converted barn, and I often wondered what she wrote home. African to American wedding. He said, Fredonia State is so big. Uh-huh. He says, in Japan, the schools are so small in college.
Yeah.
He was really surprised to see how big, and this isn't a big school.
Oh, yeah. But to us, it's really big.
Yeah.
And like, did you know that Korea is actually smaller than New York State? Really? Yeah, it's that small. Everything is so big here. Hello, we say 안녕. 안녕하세요. 안녕하세요. Well, we use 안녕하세요 to when we say to older people, so we might like 안녕하세요 like that to grandmothers or like grandfathers, but from friends to friends or like family, 안녕. 안녕하세요.
How about a short poll? We have a short poll.
Happy birthday to you, but we call it the same for you. So, 생일 축하합니다. 생일 축하합니다. 사랑하는